Assalamualaikum. Continue with learning outcome number 2, the AIDA concept. Earlier, we have discussed about the goals of promotion, which is to inform, to persuade, and to remind. And the ultimate goal of any promotion is to get the consumers to buy our product and services. It is actually to make sure that the consumer take an action to buy the company's product or services. In promotion, there is a classic model in order to reach the ultimate goals of promotion, which is called the AIDA concept. The acronym of AIDA stands for A for attention, I for interest, D for desire, and A for action. So these are stages of consumer involvement with the promotional messages by the marketers. In this AIDA concept, it is a model that proposes that consumers will respond to the marketing messages in a cognitive, what is meant by cognitive, through the consumer's mind, which is their thought. They are affective in terms of their feelings, and they are connective, which is their action in the forms of sequence. First is to think about the messages. Number two, to have feelings about the messages. And number three, to take an action about the messages. The AIDA concept assumes that promotion by the marketers will guide the consumers along the following four steps in their purchase decision process, which is the attention, interest, desire, and action. Number one is attention. The marketers, first of all, must gain attention of the target market. It is impossible for the marketers to sell something if the consumer is not aware of the product or services that is available in the market. When Apple introduced iPod in the market, it was the first of the new product of the company. So in order to create awareness, Apple must do a lot of promotion in order to grab the attention of the consumer in the current market. So Apple need to advertise and promote the product in all sort of mediums, and we will discuss about all the mediums later. Examples like in TVs, magazines, and on the internet. So with all this effort by the Apple company, it will create an attention among the consumers about the brand new product of the Apple, which is iPod. Number two, what happened in the consumer's mind is to create an interest. Of course, just through a simple advertisement in TV would not lead to any sales by the consumers. So the next step for Apple is to create interest in the product. Therefore, Apple had to arrange the product demonstration for the target consumers so that it will create an interest among them through the product demonstration. Then step number three is to have the consumer desire, rasa ingin untuk membeli. So potential customer for the Apple iPod may like the concept of the portable music player introduced by Apple. But during that time, there are few other options that are available in the market, which is by using the Sony Walkman or Sony Discman as a portable music player. Therefore, Apple had to create a brand preferences of iPod and introduce its iTunes music store with the unique features of iPod, extended life battery, a smaller version of music player with a clock, alarm, calendar, and also photo storage and etc. in the iPod features. With that additional features of iPod, this is to convince the potential customers that iPod was the best solution and that could meet the desire of the consumer during that time in the current market for the portable digital music player. And last but not least, step number 4 is action. Action here means that the consumer actually purchase the product advertised by the marketers. So in our example, iPod will convince the customers by giving extra product demonstration, by doing a lot of promotion, and also by giving discounts of the iPod itself. So these are the 4 steps involved in the IDA concepts, which is this concept interpret how consumer react towards the marketer's promotional messages. So here is to explain that as a marketer, they need to adapt to IDA concepts in order to make sure that they are able to sell their products and gain profits in the market.